Peace and love, peace and love. This is Yari, and this video is about the Mercury in Virgo transit. So Mercury in Virgo is talking about your thoughts and communication, how you speak, how the things are coming out, how you're getting your point across, you know, how you're being understood. Virgo is ruled by Mercury, which Mercury also rules Gemini. Gemini is talking about your communication and where you're flexible, where you are. There's multiplicity in your life where you can do more than one thing at once and multitask. Virgo is more of a rhythm and straight shooting and kind of one thing at a time because it's an earth sign. So it's more taking its time and using logic and reasoning, as in with Gemini is more so your thoughts, your creativity, and your ideas. So with Virgo, I call them facts. They like to stick to the facts. They like to stick to the instructions, the way that things are supposed to be. The hall monitors of the zodiac, which is what I call them. They always want to make sure that nobody's going too fast, too slow, and that's why they deal with responsibilities and duties. Just making sure everything is on the up and up all the time. Virgo, I like to also call the scientists of the zodiac because of the way that they scrutinize everything and they look at the small stuff and they put everything under a microscope because they have to understand why and they have to understand the ins and outs of everything. So you have to understand with Mercury in Virgo, this is how a lot of people are going to be thinking this month. Regardless of your sun sign, some people this may challenge them. Some people this may help them and trying the way they naturally think, the way they normally do things. Some people this may concoct some things where it's disharmony in the things that they normally do in the way that they normally think. So you have to think about where you have certain things in your chart, specifically wherever you have Pisces. All right, wherever you have Pisces, this is going to help you see clear through all of that gook, okay, and all that blurriness that Pisces sometimes gives us. Virgo, I would call it, you know, you're looking right through and putting that Mercury there is like putting on the glasses and seeing right clear through whatever fantasy or illusion or however that Pisces, which is right across from it at 183 degrees, creates. If you can see through the crap that's going on in Pisces, this will definitely help you and benefit you for the next 6 months. Also, you want to pay attention to where you have Sagittarius, all right, because this could stunt your growth in some areas that might make it hard for you to look at the bigger picture in a lot of situations when you're dealing with Virgo. Because if you're the small looking at the small stuff and you're sweating the small stuff, Sagittarius is thinking about way bigger things and in the forerun and in the future and later on. So they're not thinking about anything all the time that's right now as much as Virgo is up close on your day-to-day right now. You also want to think about what that does to your relationships in Gemini. Because Virgo is so structured and there's so much discipline and focus in the thoughts and with their intellect, all right? Because there's a lot of intellectual talent when you're talking about Virgo. But it can challenge your relationships in the way you communicate in Gemini because it can just make you come off a little cold. You know, a little cold, like a doctor or like a scientist. You know, they're in that lab all day. They don't always get to talk to people. So their people skills are not always on point. But their facts are, okay? When they're always healthy and they're always well, but they're not always around people. Think Virgo is also dealing with germs. They don't like all of that. The germs and the hoobly hoobla and being in large crowds. So it's another reason why the relationship with Virgo and Aquarius, for example, that's just a kinkunks, that's the disharmony relationship, which you want to think about that as well. You going out in public, doing different things, these groups and organizations that work well together when you're talking about the service of Virgo. But what it does when it comes into crowds, okay, that goes back to that coldness or not coming off as friendly as you could be with Virgo when you take it into Aquarius. All right, so everything that you're doing now and the way you're thinking now and the way you're communicating, as long as you stay on point, you're very careful with the things that you say. You check your mail and your messages and your emails and everything, and you check it twice with your response and that everything is going through, you should be fine. This gives you a lot of clarity. This gives you a lot of room to rest and relax in Pisces season.